If you are only using ChatGPT to write content or get answers to random questions, you're doing it wrong. This is part one of my two-part series on genius AI shortcuts that you need to know to save you hours, make faster decisions, and totally level up your productivity. From data analysis to back-end automation and more, I've got tons of practical and actually useful ChatGPT prompts that you can start using today. And honestly, number 7 could save you hours alone. So keep watching. Hey Posse, what's up? It's Alex. Now, since this video is all about shortcuts, I'm just gonna cut straight to the chase because I have got a ton of genius AI prompts to show you. In fact, I have so many to share with you that this video originally ended up being 3 times longer than my normal videos, and that's why I broke it up into 2 parts. So you will get 8 here in this video and 8 in my next video for a total of 16 genius AI shortcuts that you do not want to miss. If you're watching this video on the day it comes out, awesome. Make sure to subscribe to my channel below so you are notified when part 2 is released. And if you're watching this video at a later date, subscribe anyway, why don't ya? And I'll make sure to link part 2 in the description box below so that you can watch that next. Oh, and one last thing before we dive in, I have to give a huge, massive shout out to my amazing team who helped me compile this list based on the real life ways that we use AI here at the Copy Posse. We have a very strict AI policy here when it comes to content. We do not use AI to create any original messaging, copy, or content, but we absolutely do use it in a ton of other amazing ways to make our jobs easier, faster, and more efficient, and to better serve you, our customers. So the shortcuts you'll see in this video are not about using AI to write generic, watered down content or messaging. There is enough stuff out there on the internet about that. The prompts I'm gonna share with you today are actually way more useful and will save you a ton of time without sacrificing your message or your impact. And if you're a freelancer, copywriter, or business owner, and you like these behind the scenes videos, make sure to leave a comment below to let me know and give me a thumbs up to see more like it. All right, are you ready? Let's dive in with shortcut number 1, summarize long documents. All right, so let's say you've got this like long PDF, right? Like a 40-page industry report or white paper or case study, and you don't have time to read every single word. You just want the biggest takeaways and the actionable insights. Well, you better believe you can use ChatGPT to give you the main takeaways in like under 30 seconds. So you're gonna open a new chat and you're simply gonna enter the prompt. I'm gonna upload a long research study. Can you give me a clear summary of the top 5 takeaways and break them down in plain language as if you were explaining to a smart 12-year-old. Then go ahead and upload the PDF file directly to the prompt. It's really easy to do that. You just have to click that little plus icon in the corner to upload a document, or you can just drag and drop it into the chat, or you could also copy and paste all of the text directly into ChatGPT, but if it is long, ChatGPT will cut it off. So once ChatGPT processes your document, you will then get a clear summary with the top 5 takeaways. Now, this particular report that I uploaded is about sugar. It's just some random report that I found online. It's 25 pages long, and ChatGPT summarized the key takeaways in under a minute. So pretty cool if I really wanted to understand what was in there. And here are some bonus prompts to get even better results. Give me 3 actionable insights a small business owner could take from this report. Or summarize this for a LinkedIn post in a professional but casual tone. Or which sections of this document are most important to read in full. Or can you turn this into a 3-slide summary presentation outline? Pretty genius, right? All right, moving on to shortcut number 2, analyze data and highlight key trends. Okay, so let's say you sent out a survey to your best customers to get some feedback on a product or service you offer. And maybe you got 100 or hundreds of responses and you're really trying to figure out what people really care about, especially if it's a qualitative type of survey. Well, ChatGPT can spot patterns, key insights, and action items for you. So you're gonna enter a new chat and you're simply gonna enter the prompt. I'm gonna feed you some data from a customer check-in survey, for example. Can you identify the most common themes in the open-ended responses and give me a summary of the top 5 trends? And then just like in shortcut number 1, you're gonna upload your file. You can simply upload your CSV file or spreadsheet directly into ChatGPT. And if your data is in Google Sheets first, you can simply just export it or download it as a CSV file and then drag and drop it right into the chat. Now, here are a couple of bonus prompts to get even better results with this shortcut. Which challenges come up most in the feedback? Or can you group these responses by sentiment, positive, negative, or neutral? Or create a quick insights summary that I can put inside a presentation? Or summarize this like you're reporting back to the CEO. Short, sharp, and action-oriented. Awesome, right? All right, moving on to shortcut number 3, create specific examples to demonstrate ideas. So I literally just used this one to help me come up with some examples to demonstrate a framework I was teaching. And this can be really useful if you're teaching a course or building a presentation or hosting a masterclass or even posting on social media. Examples are really powerful and it helps your students really understand what you're saying. And ChatGPT can help you come up with them as long as you clearly explain the formula or the model or the framework or the idea you're trying to get across. So you're going to open a new chat and you're going to enter this prompt. I have a formula called, you know, insert your formula to explain what it does. Help freelancers write better social bios. I'm going to explain to you how it works. Then of course, you're just going to go ahead and explain your formula or your idea or your framework exactly like you would if you were explaining it to someone on your team, giving as much detail as possible. And that'll help ChatGPT come up with some really, really great examples. So once you've explained your framework or your model or your formula, you can ask ChatGPT to come up with specific examples. So something like, using my, in my case, VIP formula, give me 5 examples of social media bios for a business coach, a copywriter, and a virtual assistant. Keep each one short and impactful. And then it came up with some pretty cool examples that I could use to really highlight and demonstrate what I'm teaching. Now, here are some even more prompts to make them more powerful. If you want to convey more benefits, try make them more aspirational. Or if you want to match your brand voice, maybe say, hey, rewrite this in a sassy or cheeky tone, if that is, of course, your brand voice. Or you could say, great, now give me 20 ideas for relevant hooks I could use in my social media based on these bios. All right, and next up, shortcut number 4, turn frameworks into visual models. All right, so working off that last one we just talked about, you know, you just taught ChatGPT one of your frameworks or formulas that you teach in your content, and you got some really great examples. Now, maybe you want to create some visuals that you can include in your training or slides, or maybe, you know, an awesome infographic that you could post on social media. Remember, a lot of people are visual learners, so this can be really, really useful when you're teaching or presenting new information. So first, you want to open a new chat, like always, and then once again, you're going to explain your concept or model. Like, I teach a 3-part welcome email sequence called AIM, Acknowledge, Include, Mobilize, which is one of my frameworks. Acknowledge is about welcoming people to your list, acknowledging where they're at and what they're struggling with. Include is about making your new subscribers feel included in your mission and connected to your brand. And mobilize is about getting new subscribers to take action, like buying, downloading, watching, or learning more. Can you describe this as a visual model that I could turn into a slide or an infographic? And then I want to ask for visual suggestions. So I could say, what's a strong visual metaphor for this framework? Should it be shown as a pyramid or maybe a circle or a bar graph or, you know, a linear journey? You could say, describe how to lay this out in a slide deck. Or you could even say, turn this into a 3-slide teaching sequence with headlines and subpoints and speaker notes. And then, this is the coolest part, you can actually connect ChatGPT with your Canva account and ask it to instantly create a visual framework or a slide deck for you to include in your presentation. All right, next up, shortcut number 5, generate podcast show notes. So this works really, really great for YouTube video descriptions too. All you need to do is give ChatGPT the transcript of your podcast or your video. Then you can ask ChatGPT to write a detailed show notes or video description, including key takeaways, timestamps, and anything else you want to include. So the first thing you want to do is actually give ChatGPT an example of how you typically write your show notes or your video description. And then in a new chat, you simply give ChatGPT that preferred framework. You say, I'm going to feed you a transcript of my latest podcast or video. Please write me detailed show notes following this structure. title, summary paragraph, three takeaways, timestamps, guest bio, if applicable, and a call to action. Then you're gonna upload your podcast transcript. Super, super simple. So if you use a tool like Riverside or Descript or Otter, you can just download the transcript from there and then upload it directly into ChatGPT, hit enter, and then of course wait a few seconds while ChatGPT reads the transcript and then translates it into show notes for you. Now, obviously, you wanna make sure you read through this and make sure everything is super accurate and, you know, change the language so that it aligns with your brand voice. But honestly, this saves so much time of having to like listen and then translate and transcribe. And here are some bonus prompts for even better results. You can say, summarize it in a way that feels valuable to a busy entrepreneur. Or make the tone warm, expert, and clear. Or turn this into a quick summary that I can share over email. Or create three tweet-sized quotes or shareable sound bites from this episode that you can then share on social media. All right, next up, shortcut number 6, analyze social data and top performing posts. So stop just guessing which of your social posts perform best and why. Now, in most social apps, you can actually export your performance data like saves and reach and likes and captions and have ChatGPT analyze which posts work best and how you can replicate that success and create more content that works. So you can put into ChatGPT, I'm gonna share some of my recent social media data with you. Can you please identify the top 5 performing posts? Tell me what they have in common, the tone, the topic, the format, the hook, and suggest how I can actually repeat that success in future posts. Then you can go ahead and export your post performance data on whichever platform you're using in a CSV file, and just like before, upload it to ChatGPT. And make sure to include as much data as possible, like impressions, likes, comments, saves, and shares, or you can just drag and drop that CSV file into the ChatGPT window for it to analyze it for you. How cool is that? Now, here are some bonus prompts to get you even better results. You could say something like, which underperforming posts could have done better with just some small changes? Or analyze the captions. What do my best performing captions do well? Or what's the best date and time to post based on this data? Or which type of content consistently gets the most likes, saves, and shares? All right, now shortcut number 7, and this one will save you so much freaking time, write spreadsheet formulas. Now, we all know there are a lot of cool things that you could do with Excel or Google Sheets. The only downside is that you actually have to, you know, need to know how to use the formulas and how to write them and how to make all that cool stuff happen. So if you've gotten sucked down the rabbit hole of Googling formulas for hours, then you definitely need the shortcut ASAP. Just describe what you want and ChatGPT will give you the formula and explain how it works. And don't worry about getting technical. You could seriously just type something in like, I need a formula for a spreadsheet that tells me if the value in column A exists anywhere in column B, like if you're cross-referencing two sets of data, right? Then ChatGPT will give you the formula you need, which you can easily just copy and paste. Plus, it will explain to you exactly how to do it. So it is so freaking simple. And here are some other bonus prompts that you can use with this same idea. Create a formula that checks if a due date is overdue compared to today's date. Or I'm gonna upload 2 spreadsheets. Can you create a list of items that appear in both spreadsheets? Or, and this one's so simple, but I find myself needing this all the time, I'm gonna upload a spreadsheet that has both the first name and the last name of my customers in one cell. Can you please separate them into 2 separate cells? So first name is in column A and last name is in column B. Genius. And finally, shortcut number 8, find sources to support your marketing claims. So whether you're doing research for a blog post or you're looking for stats to include an upcoming email or launch or data points to help support a claim that you're making, or maybe you just want to make researching a certain topic a lot easier and faster, you better believe you can also use ChatGPT for that. So you simply need to describe what you're looking for. So start by explaining the topic and why you need sources. You don't have to be too formal. Something like, Google made some changes to email deliverability in November of this year. Can you send me some resources on that? Or I'm writing an article about the benefits of remote work for productivity. Can you find some articles, studies, or case studies that support this claim? Or can you provide links of summaries of studies on how social media usage affects our mental health? I need at least 3 credible sources. And what do you know? ChatGPT will give you a summary of what you asked for, including links to specific articles and resources that, of course, you can source in your marketing. And here are some bonus prompts for even better results with this one. You could say, give me more articles, like this one, so you could actually reference an exact article that you want more of? Or can you summarize this article and pull out the most relevant statistics for my report? Just remember, you guys, AI lies. It is generative in its very nature. So always, always, always make sure to fact check sources, summaries, and information. All right, whew, getting a little hot in here. That is it for part one. If you love these prompts, give me a thumbs up below and make sure you come back next week, because I have to say I saved the juiciest prompts for then, and I will have a refreshed and revamped AI guide for you, complete with all 16 of these ChatGPT shortcuts, plus more waiting for you in part two, so don't miss it. I'll see you next week. Until then, I'm Alex. Ciao for now. All right, guys, if you enjoyed that video, make sure to check out the next one from me right here, and you can click right here to get a free gift.
Work from home, but make it anywhere, anytime. Whether you're checking off your daily tasks at a cafe in the streets of Venice, writing copy while getting your hair done at the salon, or answering emails from a train somewhere in the French countryside, as long as you have one of these handy, you can run your business with very little interruption to your productivity or workflow. Keep watching to learn all my favorite apps and productivity tips to make running your business on the go as stress-free as possible. Thank you.